Welcome to this video on working with data in Syncfusion Dashboard Designer. This video is a walkthrough to show how to connect to your data source and transform your data for creating a dashboard. This is the Dashboard Designer interface, and whenever you open a Dashboard Designer to create a dashboard, you can see a little message over here that shows you how to start working with the data source. You can use the add button that is available over the message, or use the add icon that is available in the data sources container. This is the data connection wizard, and the drop down over here shows the list of available connection types ranging from file type such as Excel CSV, database on premises, and also your database on cloud. We also have support for other data connections such as Salesforce, Web Data Source, and many more. To know more about the available data connection types, please visit the documentation link that is available in the description below. For this demo, I would like to show you how to work with Microsoft SQL Server and prepare your data source. I have the Microsoft SQL Server installed in my machine, and so let me log on with the Windows authentication. I have the Northwind database, and let me choose it. You can also log on to your remote server with the SQL Server authentication. Let me rename this data source as Northwind Data Source and click the connect button to start the connection. You can also rename the data source at any moment from the data source container. You can use the rename option from the context menu or use the F2 keyboard shortcut. This is the data design view, where the left pane contains the tree that shows the database schema such as tables, views, and stored procedures that are available. Let me expand this node and check the list of tables. You can further expand the node and check the list of fields that are associated with a particular table. Each field comes with an icon that shows the type of field, such as numeric, string, datetime, or any other. You can add a table to the data source by simply dragging and dropping the table over the design surface. Remember, in case of Excel connection, each Excel sheet will be considered as a table. Now the products table is added, and you can see the list of available fields in this view. The bottom pane contains the data view, where you can preview the records. You can view the records by sorting a column, and also you can export selected records or the entire table as an Excel file. Now let me show you how the data can be transformed for effectively showcasing them in the dashboard. You can rename or hide an unwanted field by clicking the icon that is available over the left end. You can also include the field whenever you need. There is also a settings icon that is available over the right end. You can do various formatting operations such as changing the column type, duplicating the column, or rename the column from the menu. If your underlying data doesn't contain all the required fields, you can create your own calculated field by defining a formula on an existing field using standard functions or operators. These functions are available based upon the field type, and for a numeric field, arithmetic and aggregation functions are available. Let me create a calculated field by multiplying the unit price by a factor of 100. You can see in the data pane, the new calculated column is added. You can also create expressions or calculated fields using the sophisticated expression editor that is available in the Dashboard Designer. You can open the expression editor using the expression icon that is available in the toolbar. This is the expression editor. Over here, you can see the various functions that are supported in the designer. You can filter functions for a specific data type using the drop-down that is available. Let me choose the string type, and you can see the list of supported functions that is available. If you select a function, you can see the syntax as well as the description for the function over the left side. And over here, you can see the list of fields that is available in your data source. And very similarly, you can filter your fields based upon the field type from using the drop-down. Now, I don't need this expression, and let me delete it. And I need to include an expression to show the total amount. The total amount is calculated by multiplying the unit price with the units in stock and units in order. Let me include this expression. Let me name the expression as total amount. And the total amount is calculated by multiplying the unit price with the units in stock and units in order. Let me save this, and the expression is added successfully. You can see in the data pane the newly added expression column is seen. The expression editor has Visual Studio like IntelliSense support, which helps you in including the fields and functions. You can also include the functions or fields by double clicking the items from the list. Let me close this. Syncfusion Dashboard Designer also allows you to set default data filter. If you want to filter your records based on conditions or exclude some of the records in your data, you can do it using the filter editor. The filter editor can be opened using the filter editor icon that is available in the toolbar. Click the Add button to add a filter. The filter criteria differ based upon the field type. These are the conditions that are available for a numeric type. And I would like to choose the units on order field and filter the records with values greater than 0. You can also add multiple filters and combine them using conditional operators. In my data source, I would like to remove few records from the product names field. For datetime and string field, you can also filter records based on top n condition. And here too, the conditions differs based upon the field type. Let me update this. And you can see the data pane that is refreshed again, and the filter is now applied. By setting the data filter, you can exclude the unwanted records from the visualization when you design the dashboard. You can also add multiple tables to your data source. To do this, you can drag and drop the table as we did earlier. Let me drop the categories table, and as you can see, the table is joined automatically using the unique column or foreign key present in the table. Here, the tables are joined using the category column that are available as unique. Let me also drop another table. As you can see, if the drop table does not contain a unique column, the join editor window will be opened, from which you can choose the columns and merge the tables based on conditions. You can also open the join editor using the join editor icon that is available in the toolbar. The join editor now shows the existing join class that we have added, the details related to the left table, right table, the columns, as well as the relationship is shown. You can edit the join class as well. By default, the tables are joined using inner join class. If required, you can change it to left outer join class, or you can change the condition for merging the tables. You can also modify and update the existing join class whenever required or delete them. And also you can add a new table join using the add button. The data designer also has a query view. The query view now shows the operations that we did in the database in a query mode. Alternatively, you can design your data source using the query view by dropping your custom query instead of using the design view. Now that we have completed designing the data source, you can go ahead and start working with the dashboard. You can also save your data source for future use. You can do this by using the export option from the context menu and by saving it as a SVGS file. Instead, you can also publish this data source to your dashboard server. I have the dashboard server installed locally in my machine, and you can see the data sources that are available in the server. You can download the data sources whenever you need and also manage permissions for the data sources and share it with other users. Now let me go ahead and publish this data source in the dashboard server. I have already logged in to my server, and you can publish the data source using the publish option from the context menu, or use the server menu option and choose publish data source. You can also use the Ctrl-Alt-P keyboard shortcut instead. And click the publish button. The data source is now successfully published. And let me go to the server and refresh the list. You can see the newly added data sources in the list. In the dashboard designer, you can import the data source directly from the dashboard server by clicking the import option from the container or from the data source menu or using the Ctrl-Shift-I keyboard shortcut. Choose the server option and select the required data source. You can see the imported data source over here, and you can also re-edit your connection whenever you are going to deploy your dashboard in a different environment. The documentation link for the discussed items are given in the description below. Please take a look at it. Thank you.